So we're expecting it just to get better as we continue on with these games. The weather's broken a little bit for us, and we're about to start some D1 action here.
Illinois coming in as the number 15 seed. Colorado State the number 2. Colorado State 13-2 overall record. 2-1 in conference. They scored 184 goals and gave up just 85. They are the Rocky Mountain Lacrosse Association champions. And that is how they paved their way to the MCLA National Championship Tournament. Illinois, on the other hand, 13-3 overall, 4-0 in their conference, and they're representing the Great Rivers Lacrosse Association for Division I. Illinois scored 144 goals this year and allowed 118. Not a huge differential there, Brock.
No, not at all. Granted, I will say both these teams played a lot of different competition. The RMLC is going to be one of the toughest conferences we have out here with the likes of BYU and Colorado in there. And Illinois' conference is going to be a little bit weaker, to say the least.
McClellan's shot whistles wide of the top left corner. In net for Illinois is number 55, junior Matt Walker. Walker from Clarendon Hills, Illinois, posted a .618 save percentage, allowing 116 goals on the year. Colorado State with it now in their own end, Illinois' end. Austin Fisher behind the cage. Fisher posted 59 points. The junior from Highlands Ranch, Colorado, 43 goals and 16 assists on the year. And he was the leader in points for the Rams. This is the first meeting between Illinois and Colorado State.
Should be an interesting game today, Caleb. Both teams are going to feel each other out at the beginning, but I would expect Illinois to kind of try and slow this game down, especially with a short bench.
And a nice save there by Walker. Devlin, a good shot. And Illinois will take control, and Walker will have it in his own cage. Illinois offense led by sophomore Sam Weinstein from Northbrook, Illinois. 47 points on the year, 17 goals and 30 assists. Dan Dixon was the leader in goals. The senior from Libertyville, Illinois, had 26 of them. And freshman Max Moore from Barrington, Illinois, 66 ground balls.
You saw right there, Caleb, on that ride. Colorado State's very aggressive. It's what they're known for. And that's going to be a real test today for the Illini.
Fighting Illini take the ball over center. Porter gave it off, and up top now it's Warfield. Warfield's pass is errant. And it will stay in play to be picked up by Unkrich. Unkrich behind the cage for Illinois. Cassini had it taken away by Devlin.
It's really good defense by Devlin there, not allowing Cassini to get to his right hand, which he clearly was favoring. Devlin really was forcing him down the left-hand side, and Cassini didn't want anything to do with it.
Rams biding their time here, trying to get things set up in the offensive zone. Zach Arthur on the near side, vying for position, and he will step back, and stepping onside is Braxton Campbell. Soupy drives it to the far side, and he'll have to pull back. Tight defense from the Illini so far here, Brock.
Yeah, definitely, and Colorado's really making some changes on offense, one at a time, very methodical. trying to get the guys on the field that they want right now to run this set.
Taggart gave it up to Sean Smith. Sean Smith normally wearing 32, wearing 42 here today for Colorado State. Smith goes around behind the cage. In front, almost had a man open, and a good tip by Sean Forrest.
Caught the referee there a little bit, or might have got it way out of bounds.
Colorado State wearing the white jerseys with black trim, gold numbers going left to right across your computer screen. The Illini in the blue jerseys, white trim, orange numbers going right to left on your computer screens. There's a shot and a save by Walker. Almost a second chance there for Devlin, but Walker able to corral it in the air and keep possession. Long pass up ahead for Ben McClellan, and McClellan will take it over with 9:20 to play here in the first quarter. It's still nothing.
You know, I've been really impressed so far with the Illini's defense. I've never seen them play before, but it seems like they're very disciplined and definitely are playing some good defense. Can't say so much on offense. They're getting a little sloppy with the ball, and it's not something you can do with a caliber team like Colorado State.
Colorado State, 14 total appearances in the MCLA National Championship Tournament, a total record, Brock, of 30-9.
They've been an elite team since this league started. They know what they're doing. They run a very, very disciplined program. And actually, it's good to see their old coach, Flip Saunders, actually out on the sidelines here, helping out as an assistant coach, though this is Alex Smith's team now.
There's a shot, and it is high. Shot taken there by Tim Taggart. Had a brief conversation with Alex Smith before the game, and you can tell he just loves what he does, loves to be on the sidelines for this Colorado State team.
Yeah, Alex is a lacrosse rat like a lot of these guys out here. He's learned a lot. He knows a lot. And I think if you asked him, he'd say a lot of that is attributed to what he learned from Flip.
Off the mask, Matt Walker, a save. I don't think he saw that one, but he made the save anyway.
Big part about being a goalie is just getting in front of the ball, and you'll make a lot of saves with your chest and your face mask as well.
Have to see if he's a little woozy here in a minute. Looks to be okay. Bounce back pretty quickly. The Illini with a chance now. Behind the cage. Weir with it now. Gave it off to Spallone. Back to Weir.
Illinois setting up here in a pretty basic 2-3-1, just trying to work the ball through X, see if they can't get a matchup they like with some cutters, and see if they can't get the cage.
Starting to make a move was Kevin Ford. Now he'll have to cut back. Tight pressure on by Zaber.
Carl State's playing some really aggressive defense here. They have faith in their guys, and they know where their slides are going to be.
7 minutes to play in the first here. Spallone finds Ford. And that one will scoot away. Chatton's going to have to run it down. He cannot. And it will be a Colorado State ball.
It's the third time Illinois has thrown the ball away unforced. And it's really, you know, that's going to turn around and bite them here, because Colorado State's not going to keep throwing them right at the keeper all day.
University of Illinois, not a whole lot of success in this tournament. 5 appearances, 0-4 in winter bracket games.
Yeah, it's tough coming from their division. Like I said, they don't play a lot of great competition during the season, so when they get here, they're usually seated in the lower end, and it's really tough to come in every year and play the 2 seed or the number 1 seed.
Gribness was driving in, and there's going to be a flag down.
Yeah, that's going to be a slash to the helmet. A couple of the Illini players converged right there, and he definitely got 11 in the helmet.
starting goalie for Colorado State, Reagan, 656 save percentage for the sophomore out of Portland, Oregon, just 31 goals against. Man up for Colorado State. There's a heavy shot.
It's good movement right there. They're definitely banging the ball around. Gets the ball up top on a skip pass, and shooters are going to take those shots.
That shot was so heavy, it actually rocked the net a little bit.
Definitely. You can get these balls moving. Some of these guys can probably shoot the ball upwards of, in the high 80s, low 90s.
Wolf. Now for Fisher. Fisher is the leading offensive player for Colorado State. Taggart. Yeah, that one is knocked down.
That was really good defense by Illinois right there, getting in the passing lane and knocking that ball down.
Holmes with a shot. The long pull. Taking an opportunity, that one. Going to be kept in by the Illini. And a timeout called by Illinois with 5:20 to go in the first.
That was a really good defense there on that man down. They played in tight, and they rotated well, so the Colorado State had no passes to skip through. And I think they successfully killed off that penalty, so we're going to be back to all even here, Caleb.
Still 0-0 here in this one at the 5:20 mark. Phil Dodson calling that timeout. Trying to calm the Illini down here, draw something up.
Yeah, they're definitely doing well. They need to, like I said, stop throwing the ball away on offense and really get into their offense, work it around. And as they've shown already, they can definitely hang with this Colorado State team.
Stepping in for Illinois, Reese Southworth. Back up top for Ben McClellan. McClellan had the very first shot of the game. And he'll take another opportunity here and whistle that one into the spectator area. Definitely not a sport as a spectator you want to lounge around. Got to be active and aware.
No, you definitely have to pay attention when you're at a lacrosse game, especially at a tournament like this when there's multiple games going on. You can have lacrosse balls flying around all over the place.
Danko on the wing, gave it up to Weinstein. Weinstein driving to his right behind the cage. Good check on by Miskowitz.
That's some real aggressive defense back there. It's what you like to see. You really got to, as a defender, make the offensive player, make it difficult for him to move the ball and do what he wants to do.
Southworth dished it off. That shot is wide.
Illinois is getting some good looks here. They just got to get him on cage.
Reese Southworth. Southworth there was matched up with a shorty. Had an opportunity maybe to drive towards the cage. Back up top now is Danko. Sends it back for Kevin Ford up in front now. Moving around is Southworth. He'll take a shot and rips it wide of Regan.
It's a good job there by the defender to get to the beat the Illini guy out of bounds to turn that ball over to Colorado State.
3:43 here to go in the first quarter. Still nothing. If you're just joining us, I'm Caleb Dunlop alongside Brock Cullen, Colorado State in the white. Green trim, gold numbers going left to right on your computer screen. The Fighting Illini of Illinois going right to left on the computer screen, wearing blue with white trim and orange numbers. Colorado State in possession here. Unkrich driving in, dodges one, couldn't pull the trigger on the shot.
It's a great check by the help defender to come over. As the Colorado State midi rolled over, he just kind of ran into him, so he threw a little check to help out his fellow Illini defender.
Colorado State forced this one down, and it is going to go in. Did Matt Fisher knock that one into his own net?
No, that was definitely on purpose. That was a very, very, very nice feed from, I believe, number... Who was that? Not sure. I know number 9 finished it. That would be Austin Fisher. 42. Sean Smith with a great feed down the side. But you really can't, as a defender, let that feed get across the crease like that.
That was just a lot of bodies in such a tight area. And, you know, it's amazing, you're right, that feed did find its way through. 1-0 here, 2:40 to play in the first quarter. Colorado State striking first, it's 1-0. Smith behind the net. As Colorado State makes some personnel changes here, time dwindling down in the first quarter. There's a shot and a save by Walker. Gribness with that shot, and Walker a better save.
Again, it'll be interesting to see how this Illini team does with this Colorado State ride. They're known for being very aggressive and really, really jumping players.
Forrest took it over center, and Spallone couldn't handle the pass. Ball stays in. Ball is on the ground still. And finally picked up by Colorado State. Crossing center is Alex Devlin. Check applied by Jimmy Weir. And knocked loose. And knocked loose again. There we go. Settled down by Chris Holmes.
That's a great, great check by Jimmy Weir. Nice wraparound. Kind of baited his player, and that's one of those all or nothing checks. If he misses that check, 18's going straight to cage. But you know what? He pulled it off, and it works.
Ball is still on the floor and finally picked up by Illini Danny Spallone. Here's Nate Coburn trying to drive into the box. A good job. Tried to hold him back, but he did manage to get it in. And he is just forced off the ball by Kyle Geis. Up ahead for Porter, and Porter will drive in. Fisher back behind the cage. And that shot slips out of Matt Jewey's stick.
That's a really good back check right there by the Illini defenders as well. You know, it's kind of a scramble, but they converged on Jewey and didn't let him get a clean shot off.
Devlin, 20 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Colorado State leading 1-0.
This is the matchup they want back there with a short stick on short stick.
Now under 10 seconds to go, and he scores! Austin Fisher showing why he leads this team in points.
Yep, that's a great play right there by the Colorado State offense. You really can't let a guy like that just slip around. You got to know how much time's left, and you just can't let him score like that.
Fisher has scored the only 2 goals of the game. 6 seconds to go now. And that is going to do it for the first quarter here. It's 2-0 Colorado State, now going right to left across your computer screens in white jerseys, green trim, and gold numbers. Going left to right is the Fighting Illini of Illinois. Illinois wearing blue jerseys, white trim, orange numbers. Taking a look at how these teams have gotten here in the past, Colorado State came in this year as the 2 seed. They've been the 2 seed now since 2010, 3 years in a row. There's a shot on goal and a save by Regan. Spallone with a shot. Excuse me, that's Max Moore with the shot. And a flag is down. It looked as if Kevin Ford was offsides.
Yep, we're going to go into a man-down situation down here after Illinois can either get control of the ball or Colorado State throws the ball out of bounds.
Colorado State controlling it now behind the cage.
At this point, Illinois should be doubling the ball to try and get that ball back and get it out of their hands.
Once you go offsides, you might as well just stay offsides.
It's exactly how it works.
And Braxton Campbell is going to pick up a goal.
Yeah, so that penalty is actually going to be waved off now, Caleb, because like I said earlier, it's a technical foul. So when they're technical fouls, they get waved off when there's a goal score.
That's Campbell's first of the game. The lowest seed that Colorado State has ever been brought in was 14, and they only did that once in 2009. Other than that, they've either, one, not been to the tournament, or two, been in the top 10 seeds. And here comes Colorado State again.
I can't speak for 1997 because I don't know what happened with that year. But the one year they did show up, or didn't make it, in 2004.
05?
In 05. That's actually because they were on probation and were not allowed to come to the tournament because they were found to have been playing with ineligible players. Which I might add was self-reported, so it's nothing on Colorado State. They just found that they had a couple players drop below the minimum credit requirements, which we have here in the MCLA. And so they self-sanctioned themselves to not go to the tournament.
Roach with the ball on the far wing. Now he goes back behind the cage to X. Carter finds in front is Taggart. And that is going to run out. And it'll be an Illini ball. The highest seed Illinois has ever received was in 1998 when they came as the 5 seed.
Which, again, I can't speak to because I wasn't around the league at that point. But, you know, I'm sure they've had some good teams here in the past, and I would expect to see them really getting, here consistently in the future the more established they get their team. And there's a pretty good hotbed of lacrosse there in the Chicago, Illinois area.
That ball put on the ground, and here comes Fisher. He shoots. He scores! Austin Fisher. Hat trick goal. Good job by Fisher there, forcing the turnover, pick it up, and finish.
Yeah, he really did that one all on his own. You know, he took the ball away from the defender.
Sean Forrest.
And then, just walked right in, and while the goalie was trying to retreat to get back in cage, he just put it right by him.
And that was a good effort, too, by Sean Forrest to get back and try to cut that ball off.
Yes, definitely. Just a little too late.
12:09 to go here in the second quarter. Colorado State now up 4-0 as Austin Fisher nets his hat trick goal. Good battle for the faceoff here. Finally kicked out. And that ball still on the ground, being swept along. And finally, picked up by Chris Holmes. Walker will take it up for the Illini. Sent to the far side, near center. The Illini trying to set something up here. Reese Southworth with it, getting some pressure from Josh Gregg. A lot of pressure from Josh Gregg, really cutting out those passing outlets. There's a shot and a save, Regan.
It's a really low angle shot. You know, he could have even moved that ball or try to get a couple more steps above the goal line extended so he could get a better shot off.
McClellan's shot is high. And, that one right off the front bumper of a car in the parking lot. That was why I would never park my car in the front row to a lacrosse game.
Yeah, you definitely don't want to keep your car very close to the lacrosse balls and around.
He shoots, he scores! Colin Chatton finally puts the Illini on the board at 10 with 10:57 to go here in the second.
That was a beautiful play on the offense. You really can't do anything about that as a defender. I'm not really sure how Colin was able to corral that ball and then turn around and pop that thing, pop shelf. But, you know, that's really not on the defender or the goalie. That's just a great, great job by the offense.
Now 4-1, Chatton breaks the scoring plane finally for the Illini. And you can tell that Daniel Warfield really uses his strength on the faceoffs to muscle his opponent off the ball.
Yeah, he's kind of a little block out there, just powering people around, strong little legs, and low center of gravity. And that's really what a lot of lacrosse is about, is getting that leverage point and being able to force your opponent to where you want him to go.
In comes Southworth. He gives it off for Vinny Cassini. Here's Cassini with pressure on. And that one falls out of his cross. And push is called on Matt Dewey, so the Illini will take possession. Warfield reminds me of a prop in rugby. Just a big, strong guy, able to muscle people off the ball and allow his teammates to sweep in and pick up the loose ball.
Yeah, definitely. You know, there's a lot of different styles that you can play as a face-off guy. And, you know, some guys go for a clamp, some guys go for the pinch. And there's guys, you know, just trying to bulldog the other guy off the ball and let their teammates come in and swoop it up.
And Dewey with it. Sends it up, grabbed by Soupy. Campbell will take it over center. On the wing, back up top for Unkrich. And a beautiful job coming from behind. Brandon Smith poked that one away. Colorado State recovers. And Colorado State will call a timeout here. Justice K. Carter managed to recover that ball. 9:26 to go. It's 4-1 here in the second. 9:26 to go here in the second. 4-1. Colorado State leading on the restart after the Rams timeout. They'll move it around here in their offensive end.
Yeah, I'm sure Coach Smith here has something drawn up that he really wants to get his guys going and get that four-goal lead back here.
Devlin up top, gave it off. Behind the cage. They're going to keep it behind the cage. Austin Fisher coming up, working to his right. Now spins around. Thought he had a lane, did not. Pulls back again, looking for a shot. That one is high. Colorado State going to keep possession.
Yeah, it's good defense right there. Fisher tried to go for his inside roll, and the slide was right there. Didn't allow Fisher to get underneath and go easy to the goal.
Behind the net, huffing it out is Sean Smith. Crosses it into the middle, and that one is unable to be kept in. 8:32 to go. Good idea there, just couldn't finish.
Yeah, it was good defense as well. It's kind of tough to force those balls through the middle. A lot of sticks, a lot of bodies, like you said earlier. They did connect on one earlier, but it's not going to work every time.
Forrest with it, looking for some help. And Illinois called offside. And driving down quickly, Colorado State. There's a shot, and it's wide, taken by the junior defenseman, Corey Hughes. Or excuse me, that's Zach Arthur.
Yeah, they're trying to get a quick restart there and catch the Illini off guard, which they kind of did, but the deep ball just couldn't finish.
Ball left at center by Chandler as he will go off. Here is Tim Taggart. This one now down at X. Braxton Campbell behind the net. Picks that. Campbell rolls in. Saved by Walker. Ball is loose on the ground. Walker in a fight for it. It is poked loose out of Matt Walker's stick. Play is going to be whistled down. A crease infraction.
It's actually going to be an interference with the goalie. When the goalie has the ball and he's inside his crease, you're not allowed to make contact with his stick, and that's what the Colorado State players did, so it's an automatic ball for Illinois, and it's a free clear.
Illinois gains the free clear after goalie interference. A great save by Matt Walker on that last exchange.
Yeah, it really was a great save. He stepped out, made himself big, and really cut off the angle when the close-in shot, and really didn't give the Colorado State player much of an angle to shoot at, and came up big.
Southworth now gives it off for Danko. And Danko will run up top, try to set things up. He's got a short stick on him. That pass goes through the legs of Reese Southworth. Knocked down, ball is on the floor. Four players converge on it, and Reese wins it back. Ball behind the cage. Tic-tac passing here for the Illini. So they try to get this offense going with 6:45 in the second.
Yeah, they're definitely trying to move it around to this matchup right here, short stick on short stick. You know, it's easier to try and go to the cage instead of having a long stick middle.
He scores! Kevin Ford notches another one, and it is now 4-2.
Yeah, that was a great pass there from Southworth. You know, he drew the slide, and then found the cutter right there in the middle, and Ford was wide open.
All that passing pays off, opened up a nice hole in the Colorado State defense. Kevin Ford able to take advantage of it.
Yeah, you definitely, that's what lacrosse is about, especially when you're on offense. You got to get that defense moving, get them out of position, and then find the open guy.
Coburn and Warfield to take the faceoff here after the goal. 6:39 to play in the second. It's 4-2, Colorado State leading. And sliding down was Zach Arthur. Arthur gives it up on the wing. Up top, it's Greg. There's a shot, he scores! Zach Arthur, mid-range shot, the long stick, midi connects, it's 5-2.
You can tell he really wanted that one. He's stuck down there on offense even after giving up the ball, and he's looking to shoot, obviously, and he clearly has a nice shot because he pinged that thing right in the corner.
Not much Matt Walker could do on that situation. Now 5-2, a three-goal lead for the Rams.
No, you definitely, it's tough when you got to have a guy that knows what he's doing with one of those long poles. The velocity he can get on those things after the torque and leverage, it can definitely whip out of there.
And here come the Illini. Trying to make some personnel changes, slow things down here. Under 6 minutes to play in the second quarter, it's 5-2. Here in the opening round of the MCLA National Championship Tournament. Back behind is Ford. Long pass back up top. Spallone. Now Cassini. Cassini driving in. He's got a short stick on him, and that's the matchup that the Illini like to see. Spallone back to X.
Yeah, the Illini are running a pretty traditional 2-3-1 here. There's cutting guys in and out, trying to drive, draw a slide. But you see it's a triangle rotation here with the two separate triangles with the attack and the midfielders.
And that ball really starting from X.
Yeah, it can either come from X or it can come from up top. It depends on if it's going to be the attackman or midi driving. But, yeah, you definitely you want to utilize the matchups, and that's going to be wherever the short stick is on short stick.
Kevin Ford back behind. And so far, it's been Vinny Cassini who has had that short-on-short matchup that the Illini trying to take advantage of. And Ford cannot pull the trigger. And that was after Sam Weinstein had to run his man in the ground.
Yeah, that was great, great movement back there by the attackman to lose his defender and have him actually trip over the cage. And he had a great feed. He just couldn't get a finish off.
Jack Curry takes it over center. Jewey driving in a shot, and it goes wide. Matt Walker really guarding that near side post.
Yeah, definitely. The Illini got lucky on that one that he couldn't find Cage because the slide was coming late, and he definitely had beaten his man.
Matt Walker took away everything on the near side. That wide side was wide open, and that's where Jewey aimed it.
Yeah, that's definitely where he had to go with that shot. It's going to be stick side low, but it's a hard angle when you're running across your body. Not a lot of people can throw that Brett Favre-esque pass.
Driving in, scores! Dustin Gribness. That makes it 6-2.
That right there, Caleb, was the exact same play. Sweeping midi over the top. He lost his midfielder in the middle there, or he set a pick, and no one came for the slide, so he just dumped it right over the goalie's head.
.355 to go here in the second. Warfield against Coburn on the faceoff. And that ball picked up by Max Moore. .344 here to play in the first half. Colorado State leading 6-2. Again, I'm Caleb Dunlop. Alongside Brock Cullen as we await the end of this timeout here called by the Illini. The sun has finally come out, making it nice and hot here for us.
Yes, it has definitely turned into a very warm day and humid at that because of all the moisture that's been in the air from the rain this morning.
Now that sun is almost right in my eyesight. I wish you guys could see it, you know, from our perspective at least.
Yeah, it's moving down, and this game that we have after this one is going to be real rough, I can imagine. It's going to be right in our eyes.
The latter half of this game will be pretty tough as well. 3:44 to go here in the second. 6-2, Colorado State leading Illini with the ball here. Up top with it is Andrew Danko. Danko on the side of Weinstein. Weinstein back behind for Ford. And Chatton with it back behind of Ford again. You can tell they're definitely trying to get that ball up top where there's a couple of short-on-short matches.
Well, at this point, it looks like they're locking off Danko as well. They're just not allowing him to be in this part of the game at all. Number 11 is just face guarding him and not allowing Danko to catch the ball at all.
Shot by Southworth is way out. Just high, and Colorado State changing their defense up a little bit here.
Yeah, Colorado State looks like they just changed into a zone here. They're going to drop their long poles down and then have the two other long poles in the middle of the field with the two shorties on the outside high. So they're really going to just kind of see if the Illini know how to handle this zone here.
Back behind Ford. Rotating around is Ben McClellan. As McClellan moves up top, he's drawn a pole out with him.
It'll be interesting to see if what the Illini do with this, if they keep their man on the crease or try and move it around. The way to beat this zone is you got to really bang the ball around fast, get the Colorado State guys moving and get out of their zone assignments.
Around and around we go here. In front, Chatton. And Ford will go and retrieve it. He's got Cassini up top with nobody.
Lion are getting called for a stall warning here because I'm not sure they know how to try and break this zone by the Rams.
And Reese Southworth trying to get something set up here, trying to direct his offense. Driving to his left, now back towards his right. He's going to rotate behind. Chatton is there, open lane, shot, and he whistles it wide of Regan.
There you go. That was perfect right there. They beat the zone by getting the defender to rotate, and no one filled the gap. And Chatton had a good open lane. He just couldn't connect with Cage.
Weinstein will take it on the restart. Behind the net is Ford.
CSU now has gone to back to man and forced a thrown away ball right there by the Illini.
That pass just took off onto the stick of Kevin Ford. And Colorado State will take possession here. 1:40 to play, 6-2 here in the second. Colorado State leading. Colorado State, the number 2 seed. The Illini, the 15 seed. Here in our first Division 1 game of the day at Field 1 of the opening round of the MCLA National Championship tournament in beautiful Greenville, South Carolina. That ball put on the ground. Zaber able to recover it, though.
It was a nice back check there by Chatton.
And Colorado State will call a timeout, 6-2, with about 1.5 remaining, 118 here in the second.
At Stedman Hawkins Clinic of the Carolinas, our mission is to help our patients maintain their active lifestyle.
Back from the timeout, 1:18 to go here in the second quarter, 6-2, Colorado State leading. And Colorado State in possession on the restart. Mike Wolf gives it up quickly.
Yeah, I would imagine Alex drew something up here. He's trying to get his guys one more goal here before the half, go into the lead at 7-2, and then kind of bring it out and shut it down in the second half.
Max Moore playing very good defense there, showing why he was the ground ball machine that he was this year for the Illini. And that is scooped up and taken. It's going to be out of bounds, though. Sean Forrest couldn't quite hold it in. 52 seconds to go in the quarter. Up top. Over on the near side to back up top. Devlin controlling the offense here for Colorado State.
The Rams here in a 1-4-1, Caleb, and they really look like they're trying to get this invert going and get a guy behind and go from there. The Illini are playing a zone of their own, actually, and kind of sitting around and allowing Colorado State to bang it around the edge.
A tight zone as well. Fisher back to Devlin, now on the wing to Roach. 10 seconds to go. And that pass is going to head over towards us. And that'll end the first half. It's 6-2, Colorado State leading. We will be back with the second half in just a few moments. Second half about to begin here. Colorado State versus Illinois. 6-2, Colorado State leading. Colorado State is in the white, green trim, gold jerseys going left to right across your computer screen. And Illinois going right to left wearing blue jerseys, white trim, orange numbers. And off the faceoff, here comes Colorado State, Daniel Warfield.
Colorado State right now, you probably want to push it a little bit, try and get some more goals. Illinois has a short bench. A lot of those guys are over there sitting down. They're definitely tired. And Colorado State, in my mind, needs to push this, get some more goals, separate themselves from Illinois. Don't let them hang around in here and think they have a chance.
Colton Fatzinger has come in for Colorado State in the cage on the season. Fat Zinger, the sophomore from Thornton, Colorado. 5-10 save percentage, 49 goals against. Ford driving on the far wing, sends it back, and Illinois will set up. Chatton up top for Cassini. Southworth tries to make a move inside. He'll try it again, rolls to his left, tripped up, and a flag is down. And another flag is down. And it looks like Colorado State's going to be down two.
Yep, those are going to be a trip and probably a hold on there. So it's going to be a minute and a half that they're going to be manned out.
So very quickly, Illinois with a very good opportunity to put a couple goals in.
Yeah, they really need to get one here. They're going to be down. They're going to be up for a minute for one or a minute for two men, and then if they can't score on that point, they'll still be up for another 30 seconds for, no, that's wrong. They'll be up for at most a minute for two men. 30 seconds, they'll be up one man. Either way, they need to get one here.
And that pass was almost errant. McClellan able to switch his stick over and take that down. There's a rip by McClellan. And that laser finds the woods.
Illinois got to be careful there. You really got to have backup and not let the goalie beat you when you're up two men at this point.
Up top, McClellan again will take a shot, and he put that one right into the stick of Fatzinger.
Yeah, all things considering, up two men, that's a really, really poor shot at this point. He's got to make the goalie have to move. That goalie saw the shot the whole way, and it was a poor shot when you're up two men.
Porter with a good run here. Now back behind the cage, Fisher. He'll try to kill a little time here. Knock off that disadvantage. They are shorthanded right now thanks to a holding penalty.
So the holding penalty is actually finished now, and it's just the trip that they're going to be trying to kill off. So it's 6-on-5 right now.
Fisher with it.
And now they have killed off both penalties successfully for Colorado State, and we are back to even lacrosse.
Back to even. Here we go. Colorado State. Fisher sends a long pass back up top. Check put on. That pass scoots away. Will it find the sideline? It will.
Illinois does a really good job on defense. They're packing it in and making Colorado State make those skip passes, which are very difficult to do with that many sticks in the lane.
Vinny Cassini on the restart for Illinois. He'll send it back to Walker. We'll send it up, and a very, very good job by Reese Southworth to come down with that ball.
It's a very, very dangerous pass. He almost got Reese laid out there.
Danko with it. Luckily for Southworth, both Colorado State defenders were playing the ball and not the body.
Definitely.
McClellan with it as he rotates back up top. Driving to his right, looking for some help. And Danko puts that on the floor. It's taken by Logan Chandler, and Chandler's going to get himself a little bit of a run here. He'll spin off of Danko. Smith sent it up and almost had the connection with Kay Carter, but it went off the cross.
That again right there was good D by Illinois, and Colorado State just trying to force the ball into the middle and making passes they probably should think twice about.
11-10 to go here in the third quarter. I'm Caleb Dunlop alongside Brock Cullen as we bring you Colorado State and Illinois. McClellan on the near side.
Illinois over there was offside, so it's going to be a turnover because they had the possession. It's going to be back to Colorado State.
And making quick work of it, Colorado State looking for the cross-crease pass. Not going to find it. Sean Smith instead will gather it.
That there was, again, good D. In lacrosse, you want to just get back in that hole, try and clog it all up, and Colorado State didn't have a chance to make any sort of passes because there's too many Illini in the way.
Campbell sends it back up top, taken by Tim Taggart as he makes his way in. Smith over pursuing there was Peter Riley.
But he did a nice job there to recover, and Smith couldn't do anything with it.
Taggart looking for a lane, not going to find one. The Illini doing a very good job of putting bodies in the way. Taggart might have one here. Saved by Walker. Ball on the ground. Shot from behind the back is wide. Crisis averted there for Matt Walker.
Yeah, it was a great first save. He just gave up that initial rebound right at the feet of his goal and went right to a Colorado State guy.
Working it behind. Unkrich. And that ball is loose after it deflected off at Illini. Braxton Campbell with it. From behind, Fisher. Campbell for Smith, back behind for Fisher. Again, this Colorado State defense, some good passing going around. Walker tried to stick his big goalie stick out there and try to grab that one. Unable to. And Matt Walker gets out, able to disrupt that pass, and the Illini will take possession.
Illini are doing a really, really good job on defense back there. They're packing it in, making Colorado State try and do something from the outside, and they clearly do not want to take these outside shots. Walker's a good enough goalie. He's going to pick up those shots from 12 yards out, so Colorado State's really trying to force it into the middle, and it's just not working out for him right now.
The Illini have a lot of faith in Matt Walker and his ability to go out and challenge the ball carrier or challenge the challenge a pass receiver. And that's already caused a couple of turnovers. Max Moore drug it in. Kevin Ford behind the net gave it up. Weinstein. As the Illini get organized here, a couple personnel changes coming into the zone. Danny Spallone. Weir up top. Ford behind. The Illini very patient on offense.
Which I think is really what they need to do, Caleb. They do have short numbers. They need to make sure all their possessions count, but they also need to draw them out and not let Colorado State have the ball.
Your opponents can't score if they don't have possession.
Exactly.
Spallone up top. And that one just fell out of his stick. And he almost overshoots Jimmy Weir. Phil Dodson giving some instruction to his offense, and that one slips out of Jimmy Weir's cross.
That was a very, very ambitious shot, I would say. I don't know if that one was going to even make the goalie think twice about it, even if it did get to cage.
Spallone. Moving to his right, sends it back to Weir up top. Weir, and that pass is deflected by Miskiewicz. Weinstein able to get possession, and here's a shot.
That's the shot Weir's looking for right there. He really, that last one, he doesn't want to take that shot with his left.
7:02 to go in the third. Still 6-2 here in the third. Chatting behind the net for the Illini. And that ball is going to be picked up on the run. It's Zach Arthur, and he's got a long way to go. Covers a lot of ground.
He's that depot that likes to shoot, though.
And that ball will come over near us and into our swimming pool. Coming over to pick it up, Vinny Cassini. .639 to play in the third, Cassini. Here we go, Southworth over center. Moves towards the near side and sends it off for Chatton. Chatton takes his time. That pass was low and could not be received by Sam Weinstein, and Colorado State's got possession. Coming out from behind the cage, Jack Curry. Curry picking up a pretty good run all the way from behind his own cage into the restraining area. He thought about taking a shot. And out of the air, that one is taken by Reese Southworth. And here come the alumni. They could have the man advantage. And they're going to have to settle for setting up their offense.
Yep, Colorado State did a great job of getting back on that one. That was great D there, too.
And here comes Colorado State. Zaber taking it over center. He's got an opportunity. And that one goes through Walker's five hole for a goal. Austin Fisher nets another.
That was a great job right there by Colorado State, just getting down and pushing the ball. The Illini were clearly very tired trying to get back. You could see it in the fatigue of them trying to get back to the hole. Zaber made a great move to go to cage, drew the slide, dumped it off to Fisher, and Fisher knows what to do with that ball there.
Austin Fisher's fourth goal of the game, accounting for over half of Colorado State's offense. Coburn couldn't quite win the faceoff, and here comes Colorado State again driving in. Back behind the net is Wolf. Devlin driving in, shot and a save by Walker, and he'll collect it.
That's a really nice save right there by Walker. You know, that's a hard shot. He's getting screened kind of by the guy that's playing defense. He really has got big and made a save. Let's see if Illinois can get some goals here and try and get some momentum before we get to the fourth quarter.
Up the far side, Jimmy Weir. And the alumni will call a timeout. 4:41 to go in the third quarter. It's 7-2, Colorado State. 4:41 to go in the third quarter. Some scores from around the complex. Arizona State University leading Texas 6-2. Brigham Young University leading Virginia Tech 7-6. And Duluth leading Cal Poly 7-5.
That's a big surprise right there to me. Duluth is the 16 seed and Cal Poly is the number one. I knew Minnesota Duluth was going to come in as a strong seed. Very underrated at 16, but did not see them being up by two against Cal Poly right now.
And it looks like Virginia Tech may have tied it up over there. Chatting with it here, though, in our game. The Illini trailing 7-2. Nice pass across. Chatton wound up. Didn't take the shot. And instead will wheel out.
It's a real nice face dodge. Got his D-men to commit. But there's a nice slide right behind him.
And a little shot and a save by Fatzinger.
That was a really nice save. Good shot, too. It just didn't really get the bounce that he probably expected to get on this Watersock field.
Now behind the net. For Colorado State, the Rams trying to reset their offense here. 3:30 to play in the third quarter. Dustin Gribness with it. Now it's Mike Wolf, and he'll give way to Braxton Campbell. Walker coming up big for the Illini.
It's another great save right there by Walker. The sweeping over the top midi. And not a super difficult shot, but it's still, when the Walker's got to move his feet like that, it's a good save.
Long pass back up top. Weir holding. Danny Spallone to the far side. Illinois trying to find a way to break through this defense.
Yeah, it's, Colorado State's got a pretty stifling defense. It's one of the things they pride themselves on. They're very aggressive. They get out and attack you. And unless you're moving around and can really cut, you're not going to be able to do a lot against them. It's very difficult to drive one-on-one against the Colorado State defense.
Weinstein had the ball knocked out behind the cage, able to recover, and Weir has it. Here comes Weir. He does have the short stick. The pole was coming over to help. Flag is down. And
it's probably going to be a late hitter. Yep, it's going to be an... Yeah, it's definitely going to be a unsportsmanlike or a hit to the head. Can't really see from this far out what the referee was signaling, but it's going to be a one-minute penalty on Colorado State, and the Illini are going to go man up.
Looks like Kay Carter hitting off for an illegal body check.
That's the word I was looking for.
1:54 to go here in the third quarter. Illinois' offense has been stifled so far in the second half. Here's a shot from McClellan and a save by Fetzinger.
Emphatic save at that.
I'll say, look at the confidence just exuding out of Fetzinger after that save. Chandler driving over.
Yeah, this lead, even only at 5 goals, was still a little over a minute left in the third quarter. Might be a little rough for the Illini to overcome because of their style of play. They like to slow it down, try and work it in, but with an aggressive defense like the Colorado State plays, it could be real tough to get past.
Two very different play styles here today. The Illini very patient, and Colorado State more than happy to fire it.
Yes, definitely, and I think that speaks to the aggressive style Colorado State has, and it's also they have very smart coaches. Alex Smith knows what he's doing, and he's definitely going to utilize the fact that he has a bench of probably double the size that the line I have.
40 seconds to go in the third. Coming on, Braxton Campbell. Wolf behind the cage. And 20 seconds. Greg. Now, nearing the 10-second mark remaining here as Colorado State works this around. Mike Wolf with it under. Now 5 seconds. And he scores! A nice shot from range for Alex Devlin.
Yep, that's a good shot. You know, CSU clearly knew what they were doing there. They were looking for the last shot. They left 2 seconds left on the clock. They were working the ball around, and they were looking to get the ball on the shooter's stick. And he has picked the corner. Not a lot Walker can do on that. The defender got a stick on it. It was just a good-looking shot.
Excuse me, that is Tim Taggart on the goal. Taggart's first. 2 seconds to go in the third quarter. And that'll do it for the third. Colorado State leading 8-2 as we head into the final 15 minutes of regulation. Start of the fourth quarter, 8-2 Colorado State leading. And Max Moore will pick that one up and control it for the Illini. The Illini going left to right across your computer screens and wearing blue jerseys, white trim, orange numbers. Colorado State going right to left, white jerseys, green trim, gold numbers.
We'll see if the Illini can get something going here right at the end of the game. Hopefully they can put a couple goals in the back of the net. Kind of put a little scare in Colorado State here, but I think that's all it's going to be is a little scare.
At the half, ASU 6, Texas 2, BYU and Virginia Tech tied at 7. And at the end of the third, Duluth leading 7-6 over the number one seed Cal Poly.
That would be quite the feat. We've never had a 16 seed beat a number one seed in our tournament here in the MCLA.
Colorado State in possession in the offensive end. It's Carter with it now. As he dumps it off, Fisher looking to dodge, gets around his man, sends it up for Jewey, who's looking for a shot, but I don't think he's going to find one. He creates one himself and beats Matt Walker.
That was a real nice individual.
That was just a lot of effort from Matt Jewey all by himself.
Yeah, he knew what he wanted to do there, and he wasn't going to let anyone stop him.
Face off won by Kyle Reynolds, and they're going to put a quick one in, and there's a flag down.
You know, I don't know how I feel about that call. I think it was a pretty clean hit. He was within a step. You know, I can understand the referee not wanting to have the game get out of hand, but in my eyes, that was a pretty clean hit. Yep, that's going to be 1 minute for an illegal body check.
Reynolds pokes that one in. And we're going to have a face-off here. Looks like Coburn for the Illini. And Warfield for Colorado State. One out by Warfield. They'll call his winger over to help out. Picked up by Brian Laxer.
Colorado State's going to change their personnel here, get their man up unit on the field, and see if they can't put one more in here to make it 11-2.
Devlin controlling it up top. Over for Kay Carter. Back to Devlin. And here we go on the man up. Just sending it around. Behind the cage. There's a shot and he scores! Kay Carter!
That was a real nice rotation right there on offense. Colorado State got the ball moving around, banging it from X, and then the middies overlapped over the top and came clear for an open shot.
Now Colorado State up 11-2 here in the opening round of this MCLA National Championship Tournament. Coburn will take the face-off for the Illini, and he is going against Brian Roach. And a hold is called, so Colorado State will pick it up and run with it. Here comes Greg. And reversing and going the other way is Sean Smith. Smith had quite a lane right there if he wanted to shoot, just kind of jogging around.
Yeah, I don't know if how much more Colorado State's going to be going to goal here. And as I say that, of course, they score.
They're going to go at least one more time.
We'll see if Coach Smith has them kind of lay off, pump the brakes a little bit here, if they keep going full throttle with still 12 and a half minutes left, but this game is clearly in control by the Rams.
Now 12-2.
You know, I think that really speaks volumes about what's going on right here. Illinois being a new team, short depth, and new to the tournament, just really can't – they can hang for a little bit, but that depth and experience is what takes over in the second half in a lot of these games with teams that have been to this tournament a lot.
That last one was Carter from Hughes, and Colorado State will reset. 12 minutes to play in regulation. 12-2 to score, Colorado State leading. Reynolds moves to his left. Around up top. Brown. That shot is wide, and it will remain Colorado State's ball. Mike Wolf back to retrieve it. Wolf moves to his right, now cuts back. Colorado State really slowing their offense down here at 12.
Yeah, they are. I think they're trying to do a couple different things here, you know, because they do have a that's going to be an illegal screen. It's going to turn the ball over to Illinois. But as I was saying, I think Colorado State's going to try some things here because they know they have a couple more games coming up later in this week, and they want to be able to have all their offensive sets ready to go.
Matt Walker will jog it out. Asking for somebody to help him out. Pass over the near side to Jimmy Weir. And that one is turned over. On the near side, back into the middle. Jimmy Weir with a size disadvantage there. Or excuse me, that's Jimmy Weir with a huge size disadvantage over Stephen Unkrich.
Yeah, Steve Unkrich is listed at 6'4", 240. That's a block of a human being. And Jimmy Weir can't be taller than probably 5'7", 5'8". So, yeah, it is a big, big size differential.
10.5 to play in regulation. Colorado State leading 12-2. Same move things at back behind the cage. Sent behind by Sean Ross. And Wolf trying to dodge his man. Spins back around. Cuts back one more time. Oh, no, one more time. Dumps it in front, and Ross couldn't handle it. He had the net wide open.
That was a great move back there by the attackman. He just couldn't finish it off with a good feed.
Here's a rip and a save by Walker. Ball is loose. What a save by Walker. Cue the highlight reel. Save by Matt Walker.
Yeah, that was a great save right there. He made the initial save, gave up a rebound, and then made an even better save on the second shot.
Interference called on Unkrich. .940 to play here in regulation.
Illinois is going to continue to try and slow it down here with their short bench. Their guys look tired over there, but if they have any sort of hope of getting back into this thing and making it a game, they gotta score quickly here, Caleb.
Down behind is Sam Weinstein. Almost airmailed that one over Andrew Danko. Up top for Danny Spallone. And the Illini will move the ball around here. Good cycle going. Southworth with it. Moves to his right. Tried to shoot that one low. And it's scooped up by Fatzinger.
Yeah, that one right there was a frustration shot. He tried to shoot that ball through two guys, and it just was never going to get there.
And that shot is going to be wide, and it will remain Colorado State's ball. Walker tried to get there but was unable to. Colorado State changing up some personnel, going to slow it down here. Eight minutes to play in regulation. Braxton Campbell sends that one around back.
Again, CSU is cycling in here. Looks like they're in kind of a 1-4-1. Maybe 2-2, just trying to move it around, get out shooters at about 8 yards out and try and take some nice snipe shots.
That is Gribness with it, and he gave it up for Pepper. There's a shot and a save by Walker. Rebound given away. Ball still there, but Walker is able to scoop it up.
Again, that's a good D by Walker. Great save. But he's got to be real careful on those rebounds because he's giving them up, and they're going right to the CSU players.
And he gives one away here. Max Moore couldn't control that pass. Knocked it down, but was unable to come up with it.
Showed good ups trying to even get to there, though.
Gribness with it up top. Over for Wolf. Back to Gribness. And around the edge we go. Wolf has Lahota on the near side. That one whistled wide.
It's a real nice rotation right there. Getting that midi coming through the middle. Just couldn't finish a shot.
6:45 to play here in the fourth. Wolf fakes the pass. Now sends it behind to Campbell. And Colorado State moving that ball around well here. Campbell.
Yeah, CSU does the little things very well. You know, they don't put the ball on the ground a lot and can really bang those passes around.
Shot is saved by Walker. Score may not indicate it, but Matt Walker has played a pretty solid game.
Yeah, he's seen a lot of shots. It'd be interesting to see what that actual tally was at the end of this game, but he's hung in there very well for the amount of shots that he's had to take.
At pass of age, Ben McClellan. And Colorado State will take possession with 6:05 to go in regulation. It's 12-2, Colorado State leading. Our next game is Oregon Chapman.
It's going to be a good one. I'm really looking forward to it.
That game will take place at 7 p.m. right here on MCLA.us. The opening day of our national championship tournament. Gus Brunger lost control of it. Ball still on the ground. And a good scrum. Somehow Chris Roach was able to come away with it. Now stepping inside, Roach, he tried to find his man. And that pass found its way through, picked up by Pepper.
CSU's still trying to work this ball around and see if they can't get another goal. Looks like they got some of their younger guys in there as well now, but they're definitely still running their offense.
That ball will stay in, scooped up by Roach. Sean Ross from X. Wolf knocks the pass down, collects it, shifts it back up top for Patrick Taggart. Roach. Here's Ross. Turns, and his shot is wide. Somebody knocked it down and kept it in front for Matt Walker.
It was a great cut there by Ross. He just couldn't get his hands really free to make a good shot, but came up, cut, followed his slide, and he was wide open there for the ball.
4:20 to play in regulation as it's taken by the Illini. Ford running hard behind the cage. His pass for Chatton is high.
And that right there, Caleb, I think is really just a sign of fatigue. These guys are tired. There's not a lot of them over there. They've been out in the sun, and it's finally just kind of wearing on them here.
It is a long season, and you get to this point in the season, the postseason, where everybody wants to be. You try to find a little extra in you to play it out, but with such a short bench, you know it's tough.
Yeah, you know it's tough, and we actually talked to one of the parents, and we heard that Eli and I are unfortunately missing three of their starters that have torn ACLs in the last 3 weeks of the season. So,
and a flag is down.
That's real tough on them.
Flag down with 3:40 to play. Colorado State just going to hold on to it here.
That flag down is going to be for offsides yet again. Illinois, that again is going to be a, you know, fatigue penalty, not really thinking about what's going on and not communicating, and someone's going offside that they shouldn't have.
Whistle down with 3:23 to play. Colorado State will go on the advantage. Twelve to two, the score here. Colorado State, the number two seed. 3:20 to play. Behind the net, pass in front, and he scores. Flag is down.
That's a really, really nice finish behind the back. Great feed. He was at a low angle, so he went for the BTB, and he buried it right side. And it looks like he drew himself a nice little slashing penalty as well, so they might stay up on the man advantage.
I think Sean Smith scored that one.
Yep, that's going to be a slash on number 0-0, and they are going to be at the man disadvantage again.
Chris Holmes taking the penalty with 3:12 to go, 13-2 here in regulation. With just 3 minutes to play. Dugout. Colorado State has possession. Some bodies moving around for Colorado State as they switch up their offensive strategy. Fisher with it. That pass was knocked down by Peter Riley. Illinois had control of it, and Walker tries to come out to play it. He's out of his net. He's got to be careful. What a hit by Riley. Powering over his man, Walker able to control it.
So you like to see right there, you know, defenders down there protecting their goalie.
Peter Riley did a very good job of helping his keeper out, and that shot just over the net. Sam Weinstein couldn't finish. And he's a player who knows how to finish.
Yeah, he definitely usually gets in those close positions, and he's going to put that in the back of the cage. He just couldn't seem to do it that time.
Weinstein, 17 goals on the season. Just couldn't quite finish there. 1:45 to go in regulation. Forward behind the cage.
So at this point now, when CSU gets the ball back, they're going to have to keep it within their box.
Now 1:30 left and rotating back up top.
I really think the view right now of the Illini bench speaks volumes to how this game has taken a toll on them. They are tired, sitting down, helmets off, very, very fatigued.
That one trickles in a fat zinger, and Colorado State will have it. Now they are under get it in, keep it in. A minute to play in regulation. And that was behind the net with Mike Wolf.
I would expect CSU just run the clock off. I don't really think they're going to try and go to cage and, you know, add insult to injury. This game is definitely over.
40 seconds to go. Running around was Ethan LaHoda, who was displaced by his man.
Yeah, he definitely took the brunt of the frustration on that one. It was a clean hit. It was a great hit. But I don't think he expected it coming. He just got knocked right off his feet.
Down about 10 seconds here in regulation, 13-2, Colorado State. Going to take this one. And that shot blocked.
And that'll just about do it.
And that'll do it. 13-2, the final. The number 2 seed, Colorado State, defeating the number 15 seed, Illinois, 13-2.